interested in particle formation in the atmosphere because it's the leading source of uncertainty in our understanding of what we call climate forcing. One element of that is what everyone knows, carbon dioxide, methane, what we call the long-lived greenhouse gases. And the long-lived greenhouse gases are really, really well understood. We know that carbon dioxide is increasing, and that increase in CO2 is entirely due to human activity, to burning fossil fuels and a little bit of deforestation and other things. But another part of the system is how much light is being reflected from the sun back into space. What we found in these experiments at CERN, you can form particles in the atmosphere by oxidizing organic compounds that come from trees, what we call terpenes. And they're emitted by pine trees. Alpha-pinene is the molecule that we looked at. And we were able to show that these organic compounds all by themselves can make particles. And also, if you add charge to help the particles form, the rate of formation increases significantly. There's actually two parts to this problem. One is actually making the particle. But when you make them, they're tiny little clusters of two or three or four molecules, and they're about a nanometer in size. To influence clouds, they have to be about 100 nanometers in size. Getting from 1 nanometer to 100 nanometers is a really dangerous thing for a little particle. Most little particles die. In this animation, we represent 4 different kinds of organic compounds according to their stickiness, to their volatility. 2 of them are shown in gray, and these are the extremely low volatility compounds that can basically stick to each other almost whenever they bump into each other. And there are dark gray compounds and light gray compounds. And the dark gray ones are the ones that always stick. Light gray compounds are a little bit less sticky than the dark gray ones. The red ones are even more volatile. They're less sticky, and so they really can't stick to the tiniest clusters. But as it starts to grow, you'll see that red compounds, starting with the dark red ones, and then eventually the light red ones too, start to stick more and more. As the red compounds are able to stick to the cluster, they kind of pile in, and the growth rate accelerates quite dramatically. It goes from 1 or 2 nanometers an hour to more than 6 nanometers an hour as the particles get larger than about 3 nanometers or so. Aerosols have increased in the atmosphere over the past 250 years, and that does 2 things. One, you can't see through aerosol haze, and the sun can't see through aerosol haze, and so light is scattered back into space from the haze, and that's called the direct effect, or aerosol radiative effects. And then the other one is that particles make clouds, and so more particles make clouds whiter, and that's what we call aerosol-cloud interactions. And both of those together may be hiding about 1/3 of the total warming from the long-lived greenhouse gases. They're basically masking that warming effect. But it's really uncertain because we don't know how the particles have changed in the past 250 years. So it might be as much as 1/2, or it could be basically almost nothing. The total aerosol contribution could have been about the same. That's kind of the range of uncertainty in the problem.